हेलो एवरीवन, इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट सुपर एलिवेशन अलोंग द हॉरिजॉन्टल कर्व। एंड इट इज़ एडवाइज डैट बिफोर दिस वीडियो टू वॉच द ओवरटर्निंग इफेक्ट एंड द स्किडिंग इफेक्ट ऑन द हॉरिजॉन्टल कर्व, बिकॉज द एम ऑफ प्रोवाइडिंग द सुपर एलिवेशन इज टू काउंटर द ओवरटर्निंग इफेक्ट एंड द स्किडिंग इफेक्ट। सो वॉचिंग दैट वीडियो बिफोर विल गिव यू अ बेटर अंडरस्टैंडिंग। नाउ लेट अस मूव ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक, दैट इज सुपर एलिवेशन cant or the angle of banking. Now you see, we have seen that the centrifugal force tries to overturn the vehicle or leads to skidding of the vehicle. So to counter this skidding and overturning phenomenon, or to counter the centrifugal force as well, a certain elevation is provided along the outer edge of the road, and this outer edge elevation is called as super elevation or cant or angle of banking. So you have the cross section of the road is something like this. This is your inner radius, this is your outer radius. Okay, if you look from the top, this is our inner radius, this is our outer radius. So your outer radius of your outer part of your road is elevated to a certain extent so as to counter the centrifugal force. Okay, so your outer part of the road is elevated so as to counter. This is called as super elevation E. Okay, this is your top view, this is your cross section view of the road. Now let us analyze the super elevation. Let us find out the overall value of this super elevation that is provided on the road, and what are the parameters on which it depends. When a vehicle is moving along the horizontal curve, when the vehicle is moving along the horizontal curve of radius r, your r is the radius of the horizontal curve, and the vehicle is traveling at a design speed of v meter per second. So the first thing that will is acting is centrifugal force. Your centrifugal force is wv square by gr. Then to counter the centrifugal force, the weight component of the vehicle is acting, and this weight w of the vehicle is acting vertically downward through the center of gravity of the vehicle. And then we have a contact between the tire and the road, so a frictional force is developed between the vehicle and the wheel of the vehicle and the pavement. So that also act as a factor that counters the centrifugal force. Now let us find out an expression or the relation between the various parameters on which this super elevation is dependent upon. So we have in horizontal curve, we have suppose we had a flat surface, and now this flat surface, to counter the centrifugal force, we will elevate its outer edge. So this was your inner edge A, this was your outer edge B. Okay, and to counter the centrifugal force, what we'll do is we will elevate this outer edge at an angle theta. So this is your new position of the outer edge, new position of the road, and the vehicle is traveling at this road along the curve. Now the forces that are acting on this vehicle is centrifugal force, weight of the vehicle, and the frictional force. Now let us consider the equilibrium of forces that is acting parallel to the inclined road surface. Parallel to the road surface, and we'll have a perpendicular to the road surface. These are the axes. So in this case, since this angle is theta, so this angle will also be theta. So the component of the central force P will be P cos theta. This will be P sin theta. Likewise, the component of the weight W that is acting will be W cos theta, and here it will be w sin theta. Alright, so to counter this p cos theta that wants to throw the vehicle outward, this p cos theta is being countered by the weight component w sin theta and the friction component, right? So this friction component will be equal to the reaction that has been caused by the friction component, right? And these reactions will be equal to coefficient of friction Ra plus Rb, right? Your Ra and Rb, the cumulative force that is acting downward, the cumulative force that is acting downward is W cos theta and P sin theta, that is acting in the middle of the tire or the middle of the vehicle, right? So your component, the friction component that are acting will be equal to F Ra plus Rb, and the your Ra and Rb will be equal to the summation of W cos theta and P sin theta. So here what we can do is we have force P sin theta, P cos theta, and W cos theta and W sin theta. Now equating these, we have P cos theta, the force that was acting, is equal to W sin theta and friction, coefficient of friction F into W cos theta plus P sin theta, because we have the reaction forces that are acting is equals to the summation of W cos theta and P sin theta. So on solving these, basically what happens is that your P cos theta by just rearranging your, I should solve it. Wait a second. So what happens is this P cos theta is equals to W sin theta plus F times of W cos theta plus P sin theta. All right. Now this can be written as P cos theta plus P F sin theta is equals to W sin theta plus W F cos theta. We can take P common, cos theta plus F sin theta is equals to W sin theta plus F cos theta. All right, just rearranging these, this expression. All right, now you see this elevation that we will do is usually very small. This theta angle is very small. If we elevate the outer edge by a very big angle, so what will happen is the collapse of the vehicle will take place. So vehicle, instead of overturning outside of the curve, will overturn inside of the curve. If we increase this edge, this in, if we increase this elevation more than the desired amount, right? So the elevation is very small. So your theta is not is normally very small. So when your theta value is very small, your cos theta becomes equal to 1 and your sine theta becomes equal to tan theta. So in this case, this expression becomes P1 plus F tan theta equal to W tan theta plus F, or we can say this P by W becomes tan theta plus F divided by 1 plus F tan theta. Now यो द फ्रिक्शन दैट इज एक्टिंग ऑन दिस रोड इज लेटरल फ्रिक्शन और लॉन्गिट्यूडनल फ्रिक्शन. थिंक अबाउट इट, द फ्रिक्शन दैट इज एक्टिंग इज लेटरल फ्रिक्शन, दैट इज अलॉन्ग द क्रॉस सेक्शन ऑफ द रोड. एंड वी हैव सीन इन दी वेन वी वर स्टडिंग अबाउट द क्रॉस सेक्शन ऑफ द रोड, क्रॉस सेक्शन एलिमेंट ऑफ द रोड, द कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ फ्रिक्शन वैल्यू इज 0.15. ओके, दिस इज द परमिसिबल वैल्यू ऑफ कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ फ्रिक्शन, लेटरल कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ फ्रिक्शन टू बी प्रिसाइज. एंड the value of super elevation e is very small, and as per the code the value is 0.07. the maximum permissible value is 0.07. so when we have f equal to 0.15 and the maximum permissible value is 0 tan theta, that is never exceed 0.07. so putting these value together, your f tan theta becomes 0.01, a very small value, and subtracting 1 from this f tan theta becomes 0.99, which is equal to 1. So your p by w, that is centrifugal ratio, becomes equal to tan theta plus f. This tan theta is then denoted as e, and this p by w becomes e plus f. And in the previous, in this first slide itself, we have seen that the p by w is equal to v square by 2g, right? So putting the value of p by w, this expression becomes e plus f equal to v square by 2g. Okay, now here in this expression, the value was given in this e plus f equals to v square by 2g. The value of v was in meter per second. If we have a value in kilometer per hour, then just put the conversion factor, put the value of g, then it becomes e plus f equal to v square divided by 127 r. Okay, this is in when the velocity is given in kilometer per hour. This expression is used when the value we have v in kilometer per hour. So we have a permissible values that in plane and rolling terrain, the value of super elevation should not be more than 7%. In urban road, the value should not be more than 4%, and in the hilly road, the value is should not be more than 10%. So your hilly roads are the exceptions. All right, your hilly roads are the exceptions. Otherwise, in no case the value of super elevation should be more than 7%. Now let us in a very fast way understand the designing aspect of the super elevation, how the super elevation is designed. So your super elevation, the design of super elevation is in a mixed traffic condition is a very complex problem, because it includes vehicles from the variety of speeds. So we have at the same time we have n number of vehicles that are traveling at various speeds. Some are traveling more than the designing speed, some are traveling lower than the lower permissible speed. So there we have vehicles that are traveling at a variety of speed, right? So for the practical consideration, for the design of super elevation, the speed is taken as 75% of the design speed. All right, so if we have a road that has a permissible the design speed of 60 km per hour, for the design of super elevation we will take the value as 75% of 60 km per hour. And as we have discussed, the super elevation value is limited to 0.07, that is 7%, except in the hilly road. All right, so now let us see the design step of super elevation. So the first step will be that we will the super elevation for 75% of the design speed is calculated by neglecting the friction. So whatever the design speed is given to us, we will adopt 75% of that design speed, and then plus along with that we will neglect the friction value, and then using the formula we will find out the value of super elevation obtained. So if we have a velocity given in meter per second, then we will use v square by gr, no issue in that. बट इफ द वेलोसिटी इज गिवन इन किलोमीटर पर आवर देन वी विल यूज दिस फॉर्मूला. इफ द वेलोसिटी इज गिवन इन किलोमीटर पर आवर देन वी विल यूज वी स्क्वायर बाय 225 आर. एंड दिस कैलकुलेटेड सुपर एलिवेशन वैल्यू इफ इट इज लेस देन दी परमिसिबल सुपर एलिवेशन वैल्यू दैट इज 7%, देन देर इज नो इश्यू, विल प्रोवाइड दी ऑब्टेंड सुपर एलिवेशन वैल्यू. हाउएवर इफ द सुपर एलिवेशन वैल्यू ऑब्टेंड यूजिंग द फॉर्मूला इज ग्रेटर देन द परमिसिबल वैल्यू, सो सपोज इफ यू ऑब्टेंड अ सुपर एलिवेशन वैल्यू ऑफ 8%, बट वी कॉन्ट प्रोवाइड 8% ऑफ सुपर एलिवेशन इन ऑन अ प्लेन रोड, राइट? सो इन दैट केस वॉट विल डू इज विल प्रोवाइड द मैक्सिमम अलाउेबल सुपर एलिवेशन वैल्यू, मैक्सिमम अलाउेबल सुपर एलिवेशन वैल्यू ऑफ 7% एंड मूव ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट स्टेप. So in the next step, what we'll do is we'll find out the coefficient of friction based upon the maximum permissible super elevation value. So we will put E equal to 7% in the formula, and then we will find out what is the coefficient of friction that is obtained. And like we have discussed before, that the permissible coefficient of friction, lateral coefficient of friction is 0.15. So based upon the put super elevation value, the coefficient of friction is if less than 0.15, then our maximum permissible super value is safe and we can move on. And that is again the next, that is again the end of the question. However, if the coefficient of friction is greater than 0.15, then what we have to do is we have to restrict the speed. Now what we have to do, we have no option but to restrict the speed and move on to the next step. In the next step, what we'll do is we will put maximum super elevation value, maximum coefficient of friction, and find out the velocity. And the velocity that is obtained, if it is less than the design speed, then it's okay, then there is no issue. However, if this obtained value is greater than the design speed, then we have to restrict the speed of the vehicle by putting up the sign. All right, so this is how the designing of super elevation is done. In short, the first step is to take lateral coefficient of friction equal to 0, put E equal to V square by GR if velocity is given in meter per second. If the value is less than 0.07, then adopt the value. If not, then take the maximum value and move on to next step. Then what we'll do is we will find out the coefficient of friction. If the coefficient of friction is less than the permissible coefficient of friction, then it's okay. Otherwise, move on to next step. Here we will restrict the speed. Put the maximum value of E, maximum value of F, and find out the speed. If the speed is less than the design speed, then it's okay. Otherwise, we have to restrict the speed of the section by putting up the sign. Okay, so I hope this is clear to you. We'll do a couple of numericals on that, and then it will be how these steps are followed will be much more clear. Now let us in brief let us discuss about the attainment of super elevation, like how this uplifting of the edge of the horizontal curve or the road is done. Now this upliftment can be done in two ways. The first is by elimination of crown of the camber section, and the second is rotation of pavement to attain full super elevation. Okay, so by elimination of crown of cambered section can be done again in two ways. By first of all moving the outer edge rotated about the crown, and the second is shifting the crown outwards. So now let us discuss this elimination of crown of cambered section. So the first method is the outer edge rotated about the crown. So here what is done is the outer edge is rotated about the crown. So what we do is we slowly increase the outer edge with respect to the crown. Okay, with respect to the crown, we increase this outer edge. So this is how the initially this is done. Then in the next step here, like this, this, then this, then. So this is how the outer edge is raised. Or the second thing can be by shifting the crown outward. So as we progress along the road, what we do is, so this is our crown, right? The top part. So what we do is we shift the crown outward. Construct here. In the next step, again we will shift the crown outward. Again shift the crown outward. Again shift the crown outward. So like this, we will proceed along the road. Okay. So I hope it is clear to you that in when the outer edge is rotated, we will increase the edge. When the crown is shifted, we will basically shift the peak of the road. And the second is rotation of pavement. And in rotation of pavement, what we do is we basically rotate the overall pavement. So this is the road. This was the initial position of the road, and based upon the super elevation obtained, what we do is we rotate the road itself, right, along the axis. So the road can be rotated with respect to the inner edge. So we take the inner edge as a fixed point, and we find out. So let's say this was the initial width of the road, and we had found out the super elevation value using the designing step, and as we can see, E equal to tan theta, and tan theta is perpendicular upon base, and this is the perpendicular, which is, let's say, E. So this is E by B. Taking the value of E, we already have using the design step, we had find out the necessary super elevation that is to be provided. So we can find out the E equal to B into E. Okay, B into E. So based upon this, we can find out the amount by which it need to be rotated, and keeping the inner edge as a reference, we will rotate it. The second is rotating with respect to the outer edge. Rotating with respect to the outer edge means that just like inner edge was kept at a single point and we have rotated the outer edge, we'll kept the outer edge as a reference and will rotate the inner edge. But this is not followed because it will give you a basically negative super elevation, and this is rarely followed when we have like literally no option available and the topography is such that going for this seems to be the most viable option. All right, then we have a rotation along the center line. So in that, the road is rotated along the center, right? So part of the road, half of the road is rotated from this outer edge, half of the road is rotated along from the inner edge. So this is how rotation is done. So this was all for this topic. I hope you find the lecture useful and it serves the intended purpose. Do tell us your views in the comment section. Make sure to hit like if you found the lecture helpful, and consider subscribing to the channel. We have a lot more lectures related to this and other topic related to civil engineering. Press the bell icon to get regular notification. See you next time. Thank you and have a nice day.